Welcome friends to this chapter of Excel. In this chapter we are going to learn where are the important icons and tab and similar other things. So on the top if you see, this is the menu bar, and all those small things are like insert, draw, page layout, formula, data, review, all these are tabs. Each and every tab is having different icons. You can see each and every tab are having different icons, and all icons are having different functions. We are going to learn these functions in some other coming lectures. These icons are on a strip called ribbon. If you double click on a tab, then the ribbon will hide, and if you again double click back, the ribbon will reappear. Another method is you go on this right hand side arrow and click on this to hide the ribbon. This ribbon increases the size of the visibility of the sheet, and if you double click on another time, then the ribbon will appear again. On the lower side you see there are these are scroll bars. The scroll bars are horizontal scroll bar for horizontal movement of sheets, and then there is a vertical scroll bar on the right hand side, and you can scroll on the sheet vertically. Another method is to use arrow keys. You click on the sheet and move up or down or left or right on the arrows, the cells in the arrows. Another method is you roll your mouse to move up and down, but you would not be able to move on the left or right. On the bottom side you see there are sheets, data, course outline, Excel, sheet 1, sheet 2, these are the blank sheets. So if you want to move between the sheets, on the left hand side these are the arrows. You can click on these arrows to move between the sheets. For example, my active sheet is now sheet 3. If I go here and click right mouse button, and then I can see all the sheets available in this workbook. I can double click on this data and it will take me directly to that sheet. Here again you see A5, because A5 cell is being selected. Suppose I select D5, office supplies, then here you can see D5 is there written, that is a cell address. So whichever the cell you select, it will show the address. If I select these few cells, then you see the first cell G5 is white, and this whole selection, number of cells selection is being represented by G5, that is the first cell itself. Another advantage of cell is cell address is that suppose I want to go to cell D500, then I can type down D500 and press enter, and it will take you directly to D500. Now if I want to go back to A100 or A1, so let us type down A1 in this cell and press enter, it will take me directly to A1, like this A1 cell. This is the formula bar here. Each and every content are visible in the formula bar. We can increase the size of the formula bar with this down arrow, and you can increase or decrease again with this arrow, like this up and down. If you are having more content and all your formula is in, you can drag it down or again make it to the normal place. Whether it is a formula or it is a function or a numeric data, anything, when you click up here, it is visible in the formula bar.